probably wondering why I all gathered here today. I want to honor my father. Being the only oldest child in the family, a lot of the stuff that I learned about being a real man, I get from my father. And one thing I've always honored and marveled at is his ability for tolerance. Because, I mean, a lot of the kids, you know, 10 kids in a family, it's not the most, you know, calm atmosphere, especially with Gilman. And he just really has the ability to take all of us and just at least calm us down and put us in our places, because I know I could never do it, because sometimes I just feel so crazy. I'm like, how the heck does Dad do this anyway? When I'm babysitting or something. And I really want to honor him for that, because that's a real gift. And also for his ability to persevere. My dad, as much as you guys know, you know, he suffers from a lot of things, diabetes and arthritis and things, and he wakes up in the morning in pain, but, you know, he still goes to work, still goes to mass every day, and I just admire that. I mean, that's just a real sign of manhood, to be able to work through pain and to, you know, keep 10 kids under your thumb, you know, in all this pain, and it's an incredible gift, and I just think he's most grateful.
I did so many dumb things this year. Like, one time I needed $369, and like it was the night before I needed to hand it in, and I was like so, like this, like, oh my god, I can't get this enough for Boy Scouts, and that's like, I'll pay it for it. And he was going like to fix his car, and was going to buy me a beer until someone persuaded him not to. He was going to do all this stuff, but just like that, just lending me the money, like that. I said I was going to pay him back, but I don't know if I'm going to do it. I'd like to honor you first, Dad.
And that's extended, you know, through my
you know, into my adulthood. And that has made me very grateful that my father wasn't just an authority figure, he wasn't just a father, but he was also a friend, as well as a father. Father's the most important thing, I think, but I'm also grateful for that added blessing of that. And I also want to honor my father for being a man of God and for training us up in that way. And I was just thinking before this, and I thought of the scripture in Sirach, chapter 2, where it says, "You who fear the Lord, trust him, and you will not be balked of your reward. You who fear the Lord, hope for good things, for everlasting happiness and mercy. Look at the generations of old who see. Whoever trusted in the Lord and was put to shame, or whoever feared him steadfastly and was left forsaken, or whoever called out to him and was ignored. For the Lord is compassionate and merciful. He forgives sins and saves in days of distress. Those who fear the Lord do not disdain his words, and those who love him keep his ways. Those who fear the Lord do their best to please him, and those who love him find satisfaction in his law. Those who fear the Lord keep their hearts prepared and humble themselves in his presence." And to me, my father has always been a man who has done just what the scripture says. You know, and that's pretty incredible, I think, to have a father who also, you know, who is also a man of God. And I'm very grateful to that. And thank you so much.
Words. Alicia asked me if I like to say something, and incredibly enough, my children let me have the words. I just want to honor John for being a wonderful husband and for being a great companion. One of the things that I liked the most about him when we first met was that he was a man of principle, a man of character, and yet he was lots of fun. Anybody that's ever been at a wedding with us knows how we like to dance, and we enjoy things, and he's just able to have, just what the children said, he's able to follow the Lord and to be serious and to be committed. He was always, one of the things no one mentioned that has always been great for me is that John was always great in a crisis. When my brother-in-law that Alicia mentioned was injured, he was the man that introduced us. He was injured in Vietnam, and when my mother found out about it, the first person to call was John. We were engaged at the time, and she called John, and he just really came and helped all of the family in that crisis. And throughout raising the children, whenever anybody got sick or anything, Sir John always knew what to do, and I could always rely on him and count on him. And yet there was always fun, and there was a gentleness and a humility that has grown through the years, and I just couldn't think of a better life companion. And I just am thankful to the Lord that he brought us together. And thank you all for coming.
Well, we're now at Grandpa and Grandpa's house in New York. Ta-da. Hannah, say hello.
Yeah.
Are you having fun at Grandma and Grandpa's? Grandma at Grandma
on,
and Pop's house?
Come on out with Pop. Come on.
Hannah, say.
Come on, Hannah. Come on with Pop.
She said she was punching me out.
Yeah. Not anymore. That's when she was little.
She still does, Mom. She got mad at us a lot.
What were you doing?
We had no idea why. Hi, Joey.
Hi.
Oh. Video tape. Oh.
Grandpa said minus four.
Watching six key shots today in the round.
Was this US Open?
Where's the other? Where's the other guy at?
And that was an iron at the second.
He was at minus seven. I think the other. He was at minus seven.
40 yards, not a bad lie.
The leader.
That Lee Stegall is, I believe, minus seven or six.
Be a nine iron.
Let's him pit this one in and get under.
Yeah. Not a very good pin to shoot out of the rough, though, Mike.
I think he's forgot about the hole placement, Jack. Headed toward the left part of the green.
That's not a bad guy. I like to see him beat that other guy, this lead.
Anna is amazed.
I thought he would do better. Now, he dropped back today, I believe.
Yeah.
I believe he's minus three this morning. He's Australian.
That hurts.
Well, he'll par.
Yeah.
See, this is a leader.
Well, you want a birdie because he...
Yeah, you got a birdie. See, he's minus six. Yeah.
Perfect lie, perfect angle, 123 yards.
He hasn't done much wrong in the last 2 days.
These are the Mugen boys.
Do again. Go.
Sean, you dance.
Sean, dance. It's so easy to fall in love. It's so easy to fall in love. It's Sean's turn.
Oh, don't make him dance. Stop, Brennan, stop. Dance, Anna.
Kevin.
Dance, Anna.
Jessica.
Say hi.
Say, say.
We need to live, guys. We need to eat. Otherwise, we get.
No! Don't touch it! Hey, Anne, what are you doing? everyone who we're all babysitting for Aunt Patty's birthday. You see we have Dory here, Maria and Maria Ballet, Nikki, Samantha, Julie.
Is it actually white?
Hi. Hi. Oh my God.
It's a story.
Hey, Julie, say hi.
Roots begins at the time of slavery. Uh-huh. And then it goes all the way to his.
Well, here we are, 1993, 4th of July, at Pamela and Donald's 4th of July family picnic. Everybody's here now. It's actually 1:28 on Sunday, the 4th of July, 1993. Here's Grandpa. Still coming to the party. Got here about an hour ago. She is incorrigible. There's Michael. She was here for a week and she was cold. Who's incorrigible? Eileen. Regina Campbell, who is with child. There's Uncle Tommy and Uncle Donald. And Grandpa. Andrew, Eileen, and Myla's first son, first child, is Morton. Looks like everybody's snacking down. There's Christopher. It looks like Eileen is with child, her second child. She's due next week. God bless her for coming. Lord bless her. And her birth.
Yes. And then
that one was
excellent.
And here's Bianca. Bianca! Hi. Hi, Bianca. How are you doing, kitty? You can't fool me with that voice, boy. Where is that mouse I saw here? There he is. I see him. He's coming out of the hole. I have a killer instinct inside of me.
Is
this
dishwasher?
Forget it.
Are you receiving?
Please,
will
be safe.
Will you really be safe?
How about a hot dog?
Oh my God.
I think I'd rather have a hamburger. I think we'll go downstairs and get a hamburger.
You have to ask Uncle Tommy what time is it.
Boy, that hamburger is good. I'm glad I didn't go after that mouse. Nothing like USA grade US beef.
Thank you.
Steak.
Hi, Mary Joyce. There's babies everywhere. There's a baby over here. Baby over here. There's a big baby. There's a big baby great grandpa. Hi, Grandpa. Grandpa's waving. What happened? Yeah.
No.
We're
swimming, Danielle. You're over here.
She's both flagging.
On the chair.
Here.
No, she's here.
What are you doing?
Hey, Jeff, Pam,
Julie. Look at those eyes. Look at that baby. There's another baby. Look at those eyes. Anna just got over the chicken pox. So there's little spots on her.
Apple grape and apple juice, bigger ones of apple juice.
just plain apple juice? Can I use some of it?
There's another bee.
Yeah.
And so I don't want to be, although I know that there is an area in which I can sort of play safely, now and then I do like to burst out. I did a film called Tunes of Glory, which was madness as casting to play me as a drunken, heavy...
Keeps moving away from me, but over there he is. That's Uncle Donald cooking the hamburgers. Is Jimmy?
No, but I mean even another group.
Hi, Grandpa.
Mayan! Mayan!
Martin's going to be the father of a nation.
We're not worried about him being the father. We're worried about the nation.
Hi, Papa. No, that was too
far. But you know what it is? It's the size of a regular.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good. I noticed you brought somebody with you. If it's a boy, what's his name?
We don't know.
If it's a girl?
We don't know.
Oh, you don't know? You haven't decided yet?
We have to see the baby first.
Oh, okay. Good idea.
Yeah. Did the same thing with Andrew.
He's beautiful. I'll send you a copy of this video. There's Andrew.
July. Back there is Uncle Donald. He's cooking hamburgers and hot dogs. Very good. And there's Pop Pop. He has his back towards us. Good. There's Pop Pop. Came down here. There's Aunt Loretta. Alicia, and I think that's John, and there's Kristen, there's Grandpa. Fourth of July, fun, fun, fun. And there's the pool. So Danielle just throwing something in the pool.
Having a good time in the pool here.
Got onion on it. I don't like onion.
Oh.
Take another bite.
Come on. Look at Michael.
Daddy hold it. He's got it.
Lots of salad, everybody.
Just showed up here. Is Grandma Spinelli. Donald's sister.
And here this is at the Pam's pool at 4th of July. Hi, Regina. Wave. There he is. Who is under there? It's the daddy. Yay.
Cover for people have cameras in the pool.
Yes, who is that voice over there? Yes, we're getting ready. Look at this. The girls are starting the great polo contest. And over here we have Grandpa. Joey, go back by Grandpa so I can see you. Hi, Loretta. And Pam. Everybody over there, and there's Michelle McCarty and Grandpa Michael. All right, we're all having a great time, and there's Pam's rope. Can't get a picture here. Hi. A new beautiful home. Woo. Take more later. Say, Daddy. Woo.
The bubble cousins once removed.
They're serious, aren't they?
They are.
Every Sunday they'll be in each other's weddings.
Okay, big smile. Who's next? Who's next? Michael, are you smiling?
Dan is smiling.
Michael, I'm looking at you. Smile bigger. That's better. Thank you.
Nobody move. All right, now we add the grandchildren. Come on, grandchildren in the picture. You have
Mom,
my
niece, Matthew, like your mother.
The what?
The aunts.
The aunts.
We should shower. No, that would be weird.
Maybe I just like wait.
She comes walking down the street.
You don't think she'll come to the kitchen?
Here she comes.
We are waiting here for John Dolman to come in. We have a surprise birthday party for him. This is his 15th birthday.
Why not?
Because he wants to go out and get milk, right?
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear John. Happy birthday to you.
My birthday, John.
I'm speechless.
All right, that's it. Let's go. Let's get out of here.
Yeah, we don't want to speak.
See, girl, I told you. I didn't slow down on purpose.
Martin.
I'm gonna give him a piece of paper. Every single piece of paper. Hey, Tony, why did you... Tony, 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 Tony
Yeah. From your sister.
You want to sit with me?
You better open it quickly.
Open the car for her.
Yeah.
No, don't.
Just be there on the no.
Mother, what do you think? How many birthday parties have you put on?
I'll have to figure that one out.
One name, Don.
Our sixth child's 15th birthday, so at least six 15th birthdays.
Excuse me, Dad. Well, here we are at Cape Hatteras, North Carolina, August the 7th, 1993. Here's Nicole. Hi, Nicole. We just arrived around 4 o'clock. Actually, this clock on the VCR, the camera is bad. I mean, it's off an hour. Let's go see her. Ooh, look at this. There's the ocean. There's the Atlantic Ocean. It's beautiful out here. Beautiful day, it's only about 75 degrees. Humidity seems pretty low. And there's Maria up on the catwalk.
Hi.
See anybody else? Our house is on Marlin Drive. It's a brand new home. It was just built this spring. It costs $850 for the week.
Nice person.
Yes.
Nice people own it.
Hi, Joseph.
Hi, Dad.
A froggy dog.
Has 4 bedrooms and a queen-size sofa bed in the living room. That's the living room, dining room, living room, kitchen
area. Yep, and everybody else
area.
In the whole place.
And there's 4 bedrooms in the floor below that.
I'm looking to see if I can...